Hello everyone. Now we have a presentation based on slide 16 in the famous presentations of City University of New York by Jeanette Gornick. So since we share here presentations on the second on my second computer, beware that all the slides are on this homepage right here, on the website associated with the presentation. And now the PowerPoint is the first session devoted to country comparisons of Gini indices. Our objective right now is to replicate slide 15. Once again, here is PDF presentation in City University of New York. This graph presents the Gini indices of different countries before tax and transfer and after tax and transfer. I will speak of disposable household income the same way. It's the same things. What we see here is a series of countries. The US is at the top of Gini indices, Denmark at the bottom. The ranking of countries is based on post-tax and transfers, after tax and transfers, disposable incomes of equalized incomes, let's say. And the red bars are factor incomes, let's say before tax and transfers. How to replicate this? Well, it's not a perfect replication. It's a proxy, simply because what we will show is the latest available year on the program I will present you with. So what are we going to do in this session? It's not an introduction. We have almost introduced what about slide 15. We'll underline the statistical concept based on this graph. We'll introduce data programming. I will try not to enter in all the details you could imagine. We'll see how to do with a LISSY implementation, and I will propose you one or two exercises when you have time at some point. The question of slide 15, are the countries different and how and why in terms of pre-tax and transfer and post-tax and transfer income inequalities? Slide 14 of Janet presents this point. I will insist later on this series of points in the concept part. So this was the result, its repetition. And what you have here before we implement, we have to think of what we do. We compare inequality on the base of Gini indices. There could be alternatives to these comparisons, but anyway, we do like Janet. The issue is that there are many different programs, comments in Stata able to do Gini indices. Fast Gini, InecDeco, InecDecZero, if you want, and other SGini stuff. We'll make use of the most standard InecDeco command. Then we'll have to see what kind of country yields we want to crunch. The latest available in a set of countries of OECD, so to speak. Then, if we equalize incomes to take into account the size of the household population, we have to know what we do. Regarding equalization of household incomes, beware that there is a big tutorial of Vivancam on this topic. Here we make use of the standard LIS equalization scale, that is the square of number of individuals in household. And we'll compare disposable income to factor income only for non-elderly population. I would let you think of the impact of pre- and post-tax and transfer incomes on elderly population. But you, with the program, you can relax this alternative. You can do what you want, indeed. And at the end of the day, we make use of the standard, usual Luxembourg income study strategy of recordings. We make use of the same weighting idea. In terms of trimming extreme incomes at the bottom and the top, we do like in the key figures of Luxembourg income study, we do the routine of this. Stata programming. You know that we depend or I depend on Stata. You have also other tutorials devoted to R. So when you are in WebUI, in LISSY if you want, you have the choice between different programs. In Stata, something extremely useful is a new LISSY use syntax developed by Jörg in the team of LIS. In this syntax, what you see is that we can retrieve personal individual data such as age and sex, and also household variables such as year, country, and also pre and post tax incomes, and also variables that we will not make use of at this stage, such as, for instance, region of belonging. In the syntax proposed by Jörg, we make use of LIS variables. We make use of a set of countries defined by their usual ISO code. Very important to know your ISO code in Luxembourg Income Study. And we have a period range from 2010 to closest year until today. And then we save this extract in a temporary program. You can crunch this just once so that for your second run, you can kill these first lines and only use the crunch data so that you earn something like 3 minutes of crunching on slide 15. Indeed, it could be relevant to go immediately to WebUI. I have to share this window. We go to WebUI where the job is already done. We can do it from scratch. We clean the window. I have cleaned this window. I go to my website and to the homepage of this series of presentations. On session one, you will find the program here. You can copy Control A, Control C, and paste once you have precise. We want Luxembourg Income Study. We want data. We call this, for instance, replication slide 15. And here, Control V, we paste. And on this precise, on this icon here, we execute. We should, so when we go to recent jobs here, the first line is most recent program we have launched. We are waiting 3 minutes. And we'll obtain the final results we expect. If you click here on the job text, you already have the Stata program we have already crunched. And I go back to Stata programming. And we wait the famous 3 minutes. We hope simply there is no traffic jam in Luxembourg Income Study. So temporary extract is opened. We create a variable CCYYYY that is more convenient. It's a country code plus the 4 digit of years. We create equalized disposable income and equalized factor income of the household. We then generate a trick here in these 3 lines where we take the latest year of each country. By sort ISO 2, this means by country, we generate the max year, the most recent year of each country. And we keep only in case of year is max year, that is the most recent year of each country. It's relatively convenient. After, you can destroy max y variable. It's not vital. If we go further on the program window, we do several things, indeed, here and here. Here, we do several things that are typical of LIS key figures routine or implicit norm. We suppress households with no income or missing incomes. It's a choice. We then generate weights compatible with the idea to select only the head of household in each household, and we keep only non-elderly household population. So what do we do then? I precise the second typical LIS key figure thing is a series of tricks to top code and bottom code the income distribution. It's a very standard way LIS is doing for its own statistical presentation. What we do then, CCYYY is not a very convenient variable to create loop. So we encode CCYYY in a variable number name, and name will be one for, let's say, Austria first year, remaining in this data set, to US 2018, if US 2018 is the latest alphabetic order ranking of the population. And we will index from 1 to 3 to max. That is the maximum number of 1 to 3 ordered countries. Max will be US if US is the last on alphabetic order, so that we can create a loop. So the idea of this loop is after the LIS treatment of outliers, you will have here the creation of GDHI and GDHIF, that are Gini of disposable and Gini of factor income per individual. Each individual of the same, each household of the same country year item will have the same value. It's why then we collapse by country year Gini's of disposable and of factor incomes. And on this base, with this table, we could graph this table with some tricks, but we do not do that. I should present the values per line in this small data set we generate with the collapse. We can then graph Gini's as histogram by country year, and the graph will be sorted by the second series, that is the Gini of after tax and transfers values. And the rest here is for formatting and simply to put the value of the Gini at the end of each bar of the horizontal histogram. The last line is extremely important because if you don't have this line, you will not see on LISSY the PDF export. It's the purpose of this line. You will not see the PDF export of the graph in LISSY. So I go back to LISSY. We have now the latest new result. So job text your program, listing the usual listing, the standard listing. It's important to check if there is no mistake in the listing. And at the end of the day, the famous graph that we can copy paste in our document. Let's go back to here. I will notice, I did the LISSY implementation. You saw that the time of crunching is 3 minutes. And this is the result graph. It's a bit different to the one of Janet. We have the ISO 2 character plus year country year code. But what we see is very consistent with results of Janet. US, Spain, Israel, and the UK are the most unequal countries in our distribution. And Nordic countries are much more equal. The contrast is very clear. We also have an order of the graphs between post-tax and transfer distribution. And we can compare with pre-tax and transfer. What we see is a gap of 15 points between pre and post-tax and transfer in Nordic countries, and only 10 points of gap average in the US, Spain, Israel. A bit more in the UK in the reality. So it's easy to comment the graph. I have already done this job. Something that could be interesting and cool is to compare the intensity of redistribution between pre and post tax and transfer between very equalitarian and very unequalitarian countries. So your exercise to do now is to consider the same crunching but based on Latin American countries. Please do that. And later you can compare the most unequal to the most equal countries in the world. Most unequal is something like South Africa 2017. Most equal was early post-socialist countries such as Slovakia 1992. And then you can have fun with those Latin American comparisons between Brazil, that is very close indeed to South Africa, if you want, and Uruguay, that is almost a European country, almost in some respect. And you can compare the pre and post tax and transfers. The gap is of 0.05 points, almost. in average in Latin America compared to the 0.15, not 0.05, in Nordic countries, as we saw that. And here you have the extremes in the world. South Africa versus Slovakia, have just fun. So what we did here is to replicate slide 15, and you can replicate plus with the different comparisons you can dream of. So this is the end of the first session. Thank you very much for your patience, and see you soon for other presentations of replications of important graphs. So thank you very much. Have a good exercise, and work hard and play hard. Thanks a lot.